But we want to thank you for this moment, these moments we had together. Thank you, Father, for your Son, Jesus, and the blood of atonement, the blood of propitiation, that legal and binding transaction that transpired over 2,000 years ago on Calvary's cross, on a hill called Golgotha, ratified by the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Jesus, that yes, you came in the form of flesh, but you were 100% deity as well as 100% man. Because the word of God said the fullness of the Spirit rested upon you. That was 100% the Spirit of the living God. Therefore, that made you God-man or the Son of God. So regardless of what people are saying and how people are coming up with the ideology that you were just man who obeyed God, and therefore we can do it and we can teach you how to do it, is a fallacy, is a deception and a lie. And Father, we know that we can do nothing for apart from you. Even Jesus said, I'm the vine, you are the branches. Apart from me, you can do nothing. That's why you sent your Holy Spirit, because you knew we human beings, mankind, was incapable of fulfilling your desire in this realm without you. The men of old, the women of old had your Spirit rest upon them. That's why Samson was able to do what he did. That's why David was able to do what he did. That's why Elijah and Elijah were able to do what they did, because of the Spirit of the living God. Apart from you, we can do nothing. It is settled here. So, Father, we give you the praise and we thank you for your Holy Spirit, for your anointing from on high. Because, God, we know we are incapable of doing the feats that you lay before us to do without you. And you made it so that we cannot do anything without you. So, Father, thank you, thank you, thank you for your love, your mercy, your grace, your kindness, your compassion, your long-suffering, amongst many more things that you have had concerning us. Now, Father, we pray that you give us hearts and minds like unto yours, the heart and mind of Christ, to govern and control and influence our actions, our behaviors, our thoughts, and our deeds, our walk in this life. Father, may we give you the glory that you are deserving of because of these redeemed lives that you have redeemed by the blood of Jesus. Not only that, Father, we surrender our will for your will, and we say, not our will, but your will be done. Father, I thank you for Newford. I thank you, Father God, for what Newford stands for, the mountain, the governmental and judicial authority of the house of God, for which you are establishing in the land in Fort Mills, Father God. That it will be a sort of embassy of heaven that your children could come to for diplomatic immunity, to be saved, delivered, set free, and healed, and also to be equipped to go out to do what you purpose them to do in this realm, because Jesus is coming back soon. And he's coming back for a bride without spot, wrinkle, or blemish. May your children be unified in the Spirit with a love that is only found in Christ Jesus. May we operate and function in this love when dealing with one another, Father God, confessing our sins to one another and forgiving one another of our faults, Father God. Not holding against another an offense, Father God, but coming together and dealing with it and moving it out of way so that we will not give the enemy a footstool. So right now, Father God, I pray over all the personnel you have assigned for Newford. You have assigned for the ministries, Father God. I pray, Lord my God, that they have hearts and minds after your heart and after your mind, like unto your heart. Like unto your mind, so that they will do your will in this realm. They understand that the position they occupy is appointed to them by God, and that they work until the Lord, because that's what they're doing, kingdom business. And Father God, may they grow in their faith and maturity as kingdom sons and daughters and operate like it. Father God, not forgetting who they are or whose they are, but being reverential, respectful, and have the reverential fear of God Most High, that when they're doing the work of God, they're doing it in exception. They're doing it in perfection. They're doing it in excellence, being distinctive, different from the world, because we are called out of the world. Even though we're in it, we're not of it. So we are called to come out from amongst the world and be separate, not to be influenced by the ideologies and the ideas and the concepts and the systems of the world, but we are influenced by the kingdom of God. May it be so in Newport as you continue to open ways and bring to fruition that which you have spoken, because you said this is the year that we shall see what you said. And I thank you, Father God, for the land, for the building, for all the construction workers, engineers, architects, plumbers, electricians, carpenters, everyone that you have designated to build Newford Ministries, administration building, and the house of God. Father, thank you right now for every city leader who will come into agreement with what you said for that land, Father God. Thank you for the licensures and the permits that are required for us, that we will get them, and we will get them without hindrance. We will get them without opposition, because this is what you have ordained in the land, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that the house of God will be a house of prayer for the nation. And we, Father God, would change and shift things according to our prayers in the courts of heaven. God, we thank you right now, and we bless your holy name, and we give you the praise that's due your name. We thank you for our families. Our families, Father God, those who know you and those who do not. I pray for those that know you, that they stand firm in their faith, and they stand strong in the Lord. They continue their walk and their devotion with him, learning their purpose, your purpose you have for them, in carrying it out in the name of Jesus. And for those that don't know you, Father God, I pray for an encounter that will transform them, an encounter, a sober moment, so that they will know without a shadow of a doubt that truth has been presented to them. Whether or not they receive it or reject it, they can never say that they did not know. In the name of Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God, we do pray. And we pray, Father God, right now, that every leader you have assigned to Newport have the same heart and mind as Christ Jesus, understanding they are here to serve the vision, the purpose of Newport, and not their own dreams and visions and ideas of what Newford should look like. Father God, we give you the praise, and we thank you for revealing said vision, purpose, and plan to each leader that you have assigned to occupy positions in Newford and its ministries. We do give you the praise, Father. We thank you. I thank you right now, Lord God, for the healing of the agent, Michelle Newby. Thank you for the healing that transpired on yesterday and that continues on today, that that shoulder will have full range of motion by the end of this week. Father God, even by the end of this day, she will see even more improvement, that the pain will dissipate, dissolve, be no more, in the name of Jesus the Christ, the Son of the living God. And she will be able to stretch that arm a little farther today than she did yesterday. And as it progresses, by the end of the week, she will have total and full range of motion in that arm, and the pain and the soreness will be gone. In the name of Jesus, according to your word, so be it, so shall it be. And we give you the praise, Father, and we thank you. We thank you for we thank you for saving us, delivering us, healing us, and setting us free. For whom the Son sets free is free indeed. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is certainly liberty. Liberty to live the purpose of God in this realm. I thank you for the freedom and liberty you have given us. May we live in this freedom and liberty in obedience, Father God. Totally and completely, wholly sold out for you, Lord Jesus. We give you the praise, Father. We thank you in the mighty, majestic, wonderful name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen.